If you were to travel back in time a couple of hundred years ago, then I'd be stood in the middle of a busy waterside town. But that entire town was moved just under half a mile away so as not to spoil the view from this stunning castle. And that view takes in these beautiful landscaped grounds as well as a loch, which is a huge clue as to where I am. So join me in a couple of moments where I'll be revealing more. On today's show, we'll be taking the high road.
Now, you really have escaped the country, haven't you?
For sure.
Fabulous.
It's lovely. Rolling countryside.
It's fabulous.
And the low road, as we search for a perfect place to retire to.
Out of this world. I could sit here and look at this for hours on end.
Mm. Got a touch of the Hollywood Hills to it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Today I'm in Scotland in Argyll and Bute, and this is the magnificent Inverary Castle on the shores of Loch Fyne. The castle is the ancestral home of the Duke of Argyll, chief of the Clan Campbell, and it was the second Duke who set about building it back in 1744. He tasked his architect to design not only the castle, but also the new town of Inverary, located just along the shore, which now enjoys protected status as one of the earliest and best-preserved planned towns in the country. Later on in the show, I'll be stepping inside these castle walls to find out more about its history and its occupants, both past and present. Argyll and Bute is situated in the southwest of Scotland and includes 23 inhabited islands. It's an area full of mountains, glens, woodlands and lochs, stretching from the Mull of Kintyre in the south to the Isle of Lismore in the north. Bordering Loch Lomond and 220 miles of the Trossachs National Park, it has more than its fair share of national nature reserves, with 7 in total. With some of the most beautiful beaches in Scotland, almost 80% of its population live within half a mile of its coastline. The region is steeped in history. Kilmartin Glen has one of the most important concentrations of Neolithic and Bronze Age remains, including these distinctive standing stones. With 60 medieval castles, several world-class distilleries, and such expansive waterscapes, it's understandable why escapees would set their heart on moving to this area. The average price for a detached house here in Argyll and Bute comes in at just over £195,000. That's a very welcome £45,000 below the national Scottish figure. But this is a very sparsely populated part of Scotland. The region covers around 10% of the country's landmass, yet has a population density of around 90% below the national UK figure. So properties, as you might expect, are fairly thin on the ground, which means we could have our work cut out. But one thing this region does have in abundance is peace, tranquility and unspoilt views, which is just as well, because that's exactly what today's buyers are after. House hunters George and Adeline have lived in their current home in Ayr for 34 years, almost as long as the 38 years they've been married. The couple first met at the tender age of 16 when they fell in love over the garden fence.
Our gardens almost backed on to one another, and George would walk me home at night time. Then when we got into our respective bedrooms, we used to flash the lights at one another to say goodnight.
Admin manager Adeline has handed in her notice at Glasgow University and will soon be joining George, a former hospital manager, in retirement. Both feel the time has never been better for a change of location, a dramatic one, to the mountains and lochs of Argyll and Bute, an area where they've enjoyed numerous family holidays.
I grew to love the scenery, the quietness, the birdsong even, and something that we really want to do is wake up and have no noise.
Just to be at one with nature, actually, slow down the pace of life. It'll be good for our grandchildren to be able to experience a bit of growing up in the country as well.
Neither wants to slow down completely. They're keen to have an active role in their new community, contributing arts and crafts to local fairs.
We have very different personalities, but we make such a good team when we set about doing things, a project around the house or cooking in the kitchen. We just seem to gel and we instinctively know what the other's going to do.
I do what I'm told.
They're both keen cooks who clearly enjoy a design project, having totally remodelled their current home.
Our property's changed over the years we've had it. We've put two extensions onto it, so it's nothing like the house we first built. It's been a great family home. It will be quite sad to leave, but it's another chapter in our life we're looking forward to.
George is planning to while away his time wood turning and needs space to use his lathe.
I love working with wood. That's probably one of my greatest hobbies, is creating stuff from wood, be it skirting boards, door frames, things like that. And I just don't like gloss painting, really. That's another thing.
Adeline's looking forward to having more time for her sewing. She's even considering making some more tartan trousers for George to add to his growing collection.
I think we need a change. So, and we'll have a lot of fun doing up a different property and making it our own.
George and Adeline would like to find a house on the mainland rather than on the islands, but don't mind extending their search as far north as the Highlands. With their house sold, I'm keen to find out exactly what kind of dream home they're looking for. Well, look at this. Beautiful country. Even in inclement weather, it's gorgeous here, isn't it?
Just fabulous.
Let's talk about the house then. Talk to me about the situation and the location of the property you're after.
We'd love to have an elevated position overlooking some water, hills in the distance perhaps. Fairly accessible to a local village.
Fairly so accessible. What's that, horse and cart away?
No, a mile and a half, 2 miles.
Yeah, so that we can be part of a community, so that we can walk to the local shop, the local pub.
What about style of property?
Open to suggestions, really.
Are you?
Yeah.
Let's talk about the house itself. What are the must-haves with it?
Minimum of 3 bedrooms.
Because you've got grandchildren and children. Mm-hmm. And parents that might come up and visit.
Yes, absolutely.
OK. Mm-hmm. Any specific facilities for parents or anything like that?
Bedroom downstairs would be handy.
Thought so.
And a bathroom downstairs. Yeah.
Right, OK. King gardeners?
Yes.
How much outside space are we looking for?
Well,
enough to build a workshop to start with.
Uh-huh. Enough outside space to build some inside space. All right, George.
The garden we have now is, I would say, a town garden and well tended. We are aware we're not getting any younger, so it would have to be more of a wild garden with shrubs and not so many flower beds that need turned over every year. So we're going to be careful with the amount of land.
Let's talk budget. How much are you looking to spend?
Maximum £350,000.
OK, that's a healthy budget. My job is about pointing in the right direction, showing you the houses and reminding you of what you said you were after, but also along the way saying, reminding you of also things that might be a challenge in the future. Because this is a long-term purchase, isn't
it? Yes.
We find the right house, you can make a move on it.
Yes.
Right, let's get going then. Come on. With a maximum budget of £350,000, George and Adeline are looking for a 3-bedroom property with accommodation options downstairs. They're flexible about style and happy to do minor alterations, as long as the setting gives them inspiring views. So the pressure's on to find the perfect location. I think we've found some terrific properties, and at each, I'll be asking our buyers to guess the asking price at the end of the tour before revealing it. They say they don't mind doing work to a property to make it their own, but will our mystery house prove to be a design challenge too far? Our first property is situated in the Scottish Highlands, in the hamlet of Glenahulish, 3 miles away from the village of Ballahulish with its breathtaking scenery. The village sits in the shadow of not one, but two of Scotland's 282 Munros, mountains of over 3,000 feet. Once known for its slate, the quarries closed in 1955. There are cafes, shops, a bus service, even a local pub renowned for its food, all a short distance from Glenahoolish and our first property. Along with the peace and tranquility, I'm sure they wouldn't say no to a house with a bit of wow factor.
OK, then. Our first offering is this one here. Look at that.
Wow. Mm-hmm, nice. Yep, looks good.
What do you think about the style of the property itself?
Like it. Loving it, mm-hmm. Loving all that glass.
Yeah.
Like yep, I like the decking. Mm-hmm. I'm liking the look of the garden.
So, south is that away. Mm-hmm. We should be pleased to hear, because you've got a bit more privacy that way, but you've got gorgeous views
yeah,
there.
Yeah, lovely.
Beautiful.
So,
should we go inside?
Yep, yes, absolutely.
Come on.
Yep.
This traditional timber-framed house was designed by a local architect and built in 2005 using quality timber, which should appeal to George the woodworker.
I'm loving all the glass ooh. And the light.
How does this compare with the sort of living room you've got at home, then?
Much brighter, much ooh. Airier. Yeah, I'm liking the stove as mm-hmm, well, actually. Yeah. We don't have one of those at home, but it's on our wish list. And I'm loving seeing the bird life out the window, like close quarters.
It's not a lot of work for you to do here. Is that an advantage or...?
It's an advantage, yes. Yeah, definitely.
Good.
You'll fresh, love all the wood finishes.
Wood finishes
as well.
Are fantastic. Mm-hmm. Wood windows. Nice wood floor as well.
Not a bit of gloss paint inside,
no,
is it? You don't like gloss paint,
no,
do you?
I hate gloss paint.
Right. So, this house, it's not huge. But it's spread out. You've got that room to breathe in here. Big, wide hallways that almost feels like rooms in themselves. And that continues through to the kitchen. So if you come with me now, I'll show you. Righty-ho, another big room.
Lights.
Like this, nice and yep. light.
It's nice, like the floor as well. I like the fact that you can eat in here. I love the walk-in window. I can imagine a round table in
I like
there
space,
as well. Yeah.
Excellent. Let's take a look at the bedrooms. Let me just squeeze through here. Good, good.
The two spare bedrooms could double as a study and sewing room, or as guest rooms when family and friends come to stay. There's a family bathroom with a separate shower, plenty of storage and underfloor heating throughout.
So right at the far end is your master suite with amazing views.
Mm. Yeah, golf course and
yes.
beyond.
Lovely.
Lovely, yes.
Now you get a huge ensuite there, big walk-in shower.
Okay.
But behind you there is a big walk-in wardrobe.
Mm, that's big.
Yeah.
With such beautiful views, the whole room is configured to have your bed that end. Mm-hmm. But if you had your bed that end, you'd see more of the view, wouldn't you?
You possibly would, mm-hmm. actually, yeah.
And there's room for a double there, isn't there?
Yes.
There definitely is.
Outside, there's a generous driveway, a third of an acre of garden, as well as that all-important double garage for George's lathe.
Right then, you got a bit of lawn mowing to do, not too much.
Nope, not so.
You wanted something to do, didn't you? But
yep.
you wanted it to be manageable.
Uh-huh.
Yep. It's looking good.
Yeah, it's looking great. Like the way it stages down, decking at the front. Back's got a nice patio, not too big. Nice area of grass. The kids come, kick a ball.
It's very nice. I mean, the just stunning surroundings.
Yeah, stunning.
Stunning. There's a feeling of peace and tranquility.
Yeah. Good. But how much do you think you'd be prepared to buy this place for?
How about £275,000?
What is a guess?
Yeah. £280,000.
The asking price for this house is £325,000.
Oh.
OK. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we just thought with the three bedrooms
no
and
separate dining
no
room.
Separate dining room.
I yes. think if I was to guide you, practicality-wise, this feels like the size of a house that could mm-hmm. be quite
yes.
good for you.
Yes, yes, no, I agree.
Especially when you've got a size of garage like that.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Go and have a good look around at the house, walk around the outside space as well, and get a feel for this property, and I'll catch you whenever you're done. All right?
Okay, thank you.
I can forgive those low guesses. They haven't looked for property for decades now, and whilst it's a modest-sized house, I think what they will start to take into consideration and really come to appreciate is the wonderful position that this house gives them. I think it's a cracker.
£25,000 under budget, this timber-framed single-storey property provides an impressive living room, a large kitchen diner, a double garage for George, along with fantastic views.
Mmm, big double garage.
Nice electric doors.
This is your domain.
Mmm.
Yeah, absolutely. You could have your wood lathe in here, couldn't you? And plenty of space for all the other bits and bobs. Mm-hmm.
Excellent.
I think this house is very suitable for us. I like the airiness, the light. I like the spaciousness of the lounge in particular. And I like the size of the garden.
I like this property. I like the surrounding area and the views, especially the light in the lounge. I also like the double garage because that's people probably spend a lot of time. Yes, very nice.
Have you enjoyed looking around the house?
We have very much.
Well, keep that in your memory banks, because that's one of three. Come here, mate.
That's it.
There are more inhabited islands in Argyll and Bute than anywhere else in Scotland. In fact, there have been people living on the Isle of Mull for over 8,000 years. However, we've arranged for George and Adeline to visit one of their favourite uninhabited remote places, the breathtaking island of Staffa and Finkel's Cave. In 2001, the island, which is known for its wildlife, was designated a nature reserve, now run by the National Trust for Scotland.
Just got aboard, right?
Heading for Staffa?
Yep, thank you.
Thank you, Joe.
Thank you.
Today, our couple are meeting Davy Kirkpatrick, who first started taking visitors to the island in 1954.
So has the trips back and forward been part of your family for a while then, Davy?
Yes. We'll go back a long way, isn't it? My grandfather would row people, or sail people, if the wind was suitable, out to Staffa, but not as regularly as what we do today.
Okay.
You know, we are back and forward every day, for 7 months.
Known locally as the Eighth Wonder of the World, people have been coming to marvel at the island's famous hexagonal columns since the Vikings. Queen Victoria, Jules Verne, Sir Walter Scott and Alfred Lord Tennyson have all been ashore. The island is also popular with puffins who arrive every spring and gradually come ashore to lay their one egg during the summer.
The last time we were here, the puffins had migrated for the season.
They're just arriving now.
Okay.
I don't know about other parts of the country, but certainly we've got a saying that the easterly wind is a poverty wind. If you're in farming or gardening, then you'll know that nothing grows east. Mm-hmm. And fishing's the same, seabirds are the same, they just don't like performing.
You never get bored of coming out here then, David?
No, never. Staffa changes all the time, the light changes. Dull day like today, it's still bright. But people make it change. When you see somebody's face for the first time looking at that, I mean, it's amazing, really.
There was a young lady in the boat just there last week now. She'd just come back from the Galapagos, and she says, this is better than the Galapagos.
Oh, that's good.
That's her words, not mine.
Staffa's spectacular columns are made up of dark grey rock called basalt, formed from a lava flow 60 million years ago. The cliff face is called the colonnade, or the great face. The sound of the waves crashing in the caves inspired Felix Mendelssohn's Hebrides overture, Opus 26.
Wow, Lee!
Jesus.
Scary. So this is this as great as the last time you saw it?
This is spectacular as ever.
Yeah.
Absolutely fantastic.
It just gets better and better, doesn't it?
Changes all the time.
You see something different every time you come.
Definitely.
The eighth wonder of the world, indeed.
Yeah.
Look at the different colours. On the ceiling and the different sounds, the thundering.
Brilliant.
It's like a cathedral down at the end, mm-hmm. isn't it?
After taking in one of Argyll and Bute's most remarkable natural sights, it's time to resume our property journey back on dry land. Our next stop is to a property 20 miles from Oban in the village of Loch Awe. Top of our house hunter's wish list is peace and tranquility, which the village of Loch Awe has in abundance. It grew up around the local hotel, which opened in 1871. Along with the village stores, there's also a local pub. At the northern tip of the loch is the railway station, which first opened in 1880. The lands, once owned by one of the oldest Argyll clans, the MacArthurs, are home to St Conan's Kirk, one of the most elaborate examples of church architecture in Scotland. We're heading to our next property. The saying, never judge a book by its cover, springs to mind.
OK, then, a completely different kettle of fish is house number two. Here she is.
Mm-hmm. My first impression is I'm not seeing the best side of it, probably.
Yep, correct. But that's good. That's a, that's a half-full way of looking at things, because you know we've just pulled off the road.
Yes.
OK? Everything with this house faces that away.
Hiding behind this exterior is one of the finest vistas from a property I've ever seen.
Now, I'm going to tease this view out of you. I'll show you small bits slowly.
OK.
Now, what do we think of this kitchen, first of all?
Yep,
yes,
liking
like
it.
That.
Very stylish.
Definitely like it.
Like the island with the hob on it. I like the fact I can see you all the way through. I can see water from here. Yeah.
This just pulls you in. Let's kind of have a look.
Absolutely.
Positive vibes, but I get the feeling the kitchen in this property won't be where Adeline and George will be spending most of their time.
You don't often get to look around houses with views like this. No. I certainly don't.
No.
Wonderful, isn't it? Absolutely gorgeous. Yeah. Out of this world. I could sit here and look at this for hours on end.
Mm. Stunning, isn't it?
It is
absolutely
beautiful.
Again,
nice wood finish, wood floor.
And I love the wood stairs.
Do you know about gallery effect?
I think,
yes, I do.
Yes.
I think it's important to have that just so you can bring some of this view in. Mm. Otherwise, you probably wouldn't see a great deal of the water through these windows.
Uh-huh. And you can also sit there and have the view as well.
A touch of the Hollywood Hills to it, isn't it?
The property's been laid out to make the most of this fantastic view. As well as the lounge at the back of the house, three of the four bedrooms look directly onto the loch, all with their own bathroom. I'm taking them to the master bedroom at the end of the hallway.
So right at the far end of the house is your master bedroom. Ensuite and a dressing area.
Jake.
Fabulous. Lovely view again.
Mm-hmm. Of course, yeah.
Yep. Not a huge room, but...
Ample for a bit.
Yeah.
If you were to make changes in the long run, would you think about maybe doing something with the windows?
Yes.
Probably we could make it into one big window.
Yeah.
Or actually this room would benefit from a floor-to-ceiling window.
French doors even.
Yeah, that would be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
The thing with this house is there is decking that goes right across the length of the house at the back.
Okay.
And so to have French windows opening out onto that decking, I think it would transform this room.
Yes. It would make it more light as well.
Definitely. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. Great
idea.
I agree. Yeah.
Might make you less reluctant to go to bed.
Outside of the front, there's plenty of parking as well as a single car garage, whilst at the back, the spectacular outlook stretches all the way across Loch Hall.
Well, a great spot to finish on, isn't it? As we've got through that house, we've got closer and closer to this vista. Is this what you had in mind? You said, oh, let's move up to Argyll and Bute.
Yes.
Spend a bit of time. This is it, is it?
Yes.
This is it, absolutely.
But how much would it cost you to buy a place like this?
I'd probably say about 315,000.
Okay.
I'm going to go up to 325.
Good news is that the asking price for this house is offers over £300,000.
Okay. Mm. I thought the view would boost it even more.
I thought so too.
It's been on the market for over a year, this place, at the same price.
Okay.
There's a deal to be done. I sniffed it in the air. The breeze wafted off that lock and I smelt the deal.
Yeah.
OK, well, this is your opportunity to have a look at this house without me buzzing around in your ears. Have a good look around. I'll catch you later on.
OK.
Right.
Sold on the setting, this property comes in £50,000 under budget and provides a generous four bedrooms, all en suite, leaving money for them to make their own decorative mark.
Yeah, this is a good sized room, isn't it, as well? Another en suite.
Another light windows place.
Yeah, this would work for a spare bedroom.
I like this property, especially the view. It's absolutely fantastic. Slight downside for me, there's a couple of flat roofs, a couple of windows that need to be widened, etc. But I think we could make it into something that we both like.
I think this property is stunning, it's beautiful. I love the way that the kitchen flows through to the dining room, to the lounge, and that at all times you've got this beautiful view behind me. yes, I think we could be very, very happy here.
Well, that's the end of this house tour, unfortunately. You're probably quite aggrieved about that, aren't you?
Yes, the view is lovely.
Well, this is the last thing we're seeing today. Remember that.
Yep.
Remember how it made you feel, and think about it and talk about it over dinner.
Definitely.
Should we go?
Yes. Yeah.
Moving to Argyll and Bute from Ayr has been a lifelong dream for retired couple George and Adeline, who have spent many family holidays here. Now, with their home sold and a £350,000 budget, the couple are raring to go. Still to come, a mystery house in splendid isolation.
Well, then I'll stand over here so you can take in the view that you might wake up to.
Yes, please.
Yes, that's nice.
That's why you're coming to live in the country.
And I explore one of Scotland's most forbidding fortresses.
Look at that.
This has reputedly got the highest ceiling of any private house in Scotland. 71 feet. Be up to the ceiling top there.
Cleans the windows.
Oh, don't worry, we've got people to clean the windows.
So, two good properties under our belt. So I think it's fair to say that the houses themselves went down well. The first property had the peace and tranquility that Adeline and George are after, whereas house number two, well, it certainly had the view. Now, for today's mystery property, I think it's the house itself that may prove a challenge. But if George and Adeline are able to get their heads around making that work, they'll be rewarded with not only peace and tranquility, but also a sensational view. Let's see how we go. Sometimes we look at an element of your search and run with it. What do you think we might have run with?
Well, we've already run with the views, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
So what will it be, gardening? Oh, or it could be George's workshop.
Yes, we've got your warehouse with a bit of living accommodation.
A little flat above.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't mind that so much, would you?
Nah. That'd be fine.
The final stop on our house hunt takes us to the Victorian harbour town of Oban, seafood capital of Scotland, and our mystery house. With its Horseshoe Bay, Oban is the largest town between Helensburgh and Fort William, and would be George and Adeline's local town. It has a thriving community, many of whom speak Gaelic, with shops, theatre, cinema, and even an annual Highland Games.
Right then, here we are, Oban. Now, you've been here before.
Yes.
So when did you first come here?
I think when we were 18 and we were teenagers and we came on a camping holiday.
And it absolutely poured all the time.
Yeah. You've been back since?
Oh, yes. Many times.
Yeah?
Particularly to access the islands.
The challenge here is the mystery property is located around 15 minutes from here. All right?
Yes,
yep,
that
seems
that.
Fine to us.
That's fine?
Yep, good. No problem
that's
at good. All.
Today's mystery proposition is located in the hillside glen of Lerags. If George and Adeline are serious about enjoying splendid isolation, this mystery property will surely test their resolve.
Mm. Now then, the mystery house.
Ah, looking good.
Yes.
This is the oldest property out of all three. This is 1950s.
It's okay. Probably good room sizes.
I think this place could keep you busy for a couple of years.
Mm-hmm.
You want that, don't you?
Yes. Yes. Yeah, definitely.
There is some lateral thinking as well in terms of the configuration and perhaps getting up to speed in regards to your own specifications. They are the compromises, but if you're able to overlook those, you get this.
Yeah. It is lovely. Rolling countryside.
Yeah, it's fabulous.
Yeah, mix of trees, animals and the loch in the distance.
So, you're happy with what you see so far?
Yes.
Let's have a look inside.
There's no doubting the unique position and stunning views of this mystery offering. The question is, are they really ready to get stuck into a renovation project? Access via the rear porch past the shower room leads directly into the kitchen.
Rightio, what do you think of the kitchen, first of all?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's small. But we could redesign it.
This is certainly just a kitchen for cooking in. Mm-hmm. Is that okay?
It's fine. It's square. It's got some nooks and crannies, so you could actually use those to give it some features, actually, if you were to redesign it.
I was armed with all sorts of reasons why this is okay and what we could do to it, but if it's fine, fantastic news. Mm-hmm. Let's keep going. Now, this is one of two reception rooms.
Very different, yes. Isn't it?
This is an opportunity for someone to come in here and turn it from a holiday home to a full-time home.
We've clearly got something going on out here. It's like a little porch.
Mm. The room needs to face down towards that sea lock, doesn't it?
You need the panoramic view, don't you?
And you don't. You'd like to be able to walk up to the window anyway.
I do.
There you go, then.
So far, we can definitely see the potential. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Good. Excellent. Looks like this gamble might be paying off. Let me just squeeze past. Let's have a quick peek into one of the bedrooms. Well, then I'll stand over here so you can take in the view that you might wake up to.
Yes, please.
Yes, that's nice.
Excellent.
Nice size room too. Yes. Either that or I'll put in full size windows.
Walk out, actually, into the garden with your cup of tea in the morning.
Oh.
So that's why you're coming to live in the country.
This is all very good, isn't it?
It is.
Happy with this one.
Laid out on one level, this mystery property delivers their three bedrooms. From the central hallway are two singles, with one currently used as a study, along with a bright family bathroom. At the other end of the property, there's a large conservatory, where Adeline and George can sit on a rainy day and still enjoy that beautiful view.
Robin, if you've got one reception room in the main part of the house, what do you use this one for?
Yeah, everyday living, I think, because you've got an all-round view, haven't you?
Definitely.
So, when you move in, what's the first job you do?
I think it'd have to be the kitchen.
Yeah. Just muck around with that, make it a bit more...
Get that. Probably take away the shower room.
Yeah.
Bit of utility and...
This isn't configured how the other two more modern houses were. This has been added on to because it's, you know...
You can tell by the different styles that we're seeing everywhere.
Need continuity throughout, if we can.
Yeah.
That will take time.
Yes. It will do.
That's all.
Yes.
But you don't mind taking time, spending that time and money on making something more to your tastes if you get the foundations right.
Yes. And this is definitely a beautiful room.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
Should we go outside?
Yes, please.
This is where.
The large detached garage to the rear of the house has the all-important space for George's woodworking and a self-contained room to the side for all of Adeline's sewing. There's even a platform for watching the wildlife. Double doors lead from the property into the secluded private garden with its incredible unobstructed views all the way to Loch Fearnock.
Now, you really have escaped the country, haven't you?
For sure.
Fabulous.
It is, it's wonderful.
The obvious boundary there is his fence. Mm-hmm. And that goes down there, just downhill, just past those trees. And you can hear, if you listen carefully, a stream.
Yep.
The stream is your boundary, all the way around.
Okay.
It might be a bit busier than you'd initially imagined.
Yep. Yeah.
But it's what you do with it. I mean, what do you think about keeping some sheep?
No, thanks.
Right then, time now to guess the price.
It's got to be at least £300,000.
OK, then.
I'm going to go for £305,000.
This mystery house is on the market for offers in the region of £280,000.
Wow, okay. OK, so it is reflecting the fact that it needs some upgrading.
I think so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is a place you'd be happy to get lost in.
Yeah.
And we've got a bit of time, so go and do just that.
Okay, thank you very much.
Enjoy this place.
Set in spectacular surroundings, the mystery property rings in a sizeable £70,000 under budget, leaving plenty of cash to modernise. With three bedrooms and a large outbuilding for George, it also has acreage to enjoy.
This is beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, you see the stream too.
Yeah, it's quite sheltered here. Yes, I could imagine sitting here with a glass of wine, couldn't you?
This is my favourite property out of the three we've seen because of the views and the potential the house has.
I love the mystery property. I think it has lots of potential. It's a smallish house in need of significant upgrade, particularly probably in the kitchen and the bathroom. An awful lot of mix of styles that we'd have to try and bring together and get some sort of consistency. But I love what I've seen.
I reckon, for my mind, that's probably three properties in the running now, isn't it?
Yes, they've all had something really unique and welcoming about them.
Yes.
Which is what you're after, isn't it? Thankfully for you, You've got about an hour's worth of my driving to think things through. We'll find a quiet spot and then have a bit of a chat, shall we?
That's right.
Come on.
Inverary Castle has been the family seat of the Duke of Argyll since the 17th century. It's one of Argyll's great historic attractions, drawing in around 85,000 visitors a year. The 65,000-acre estate is no ordinary stately home, having a diverse range of environmentally friendly businesses, including wind and hydropower. I'm meeting estate manager Hugh Nicol.
You have a huge job here, don't you? And how much land are you responsible for, first of all?
Well, the easy answer to that is it's about 85 square miles. Broken down in common terms.
That's a country.
Yes.
You just have a crown.
It's a large area, yes.
85 square miles.
Yes.
One of the first things the 13th Duke did when he and his family moved into the castle in 2002 was to install biomass central heating. Up until then, the only heat came from open fires.
Now, you're not just burning logs here, are you?
No. What we do is we take the best logs and they go for construction and other products. The lower quality, thinner end of the tree, we take and we chip and we dry and we use for biomass energy.
Right, OK. And then, of course, once you've used that biomass energy, you replace the trees that you've taken out of the ground here?
Yes, that's the closed part of the cycle. So the carbon that's released from burning the chip is recaptured by the replanting of new trees and more new trees.
It's quite a simple cycle, isn't it?
It's the way we have to go as a society.
Yeah, it's certainly environmentally friendly.
Do you heat the castle with some of this timber?
Yep. Heating and hot water at the castle is covered by, as is one of the local hotels and other businesses. We export quite a lot of it as well to other parts around the country.
I understand we're going to be planting a couple of trees ourselves.
Yeah, we'll have a go. Right, you do the whole lot.
Stick her in, nice and deep.
And we'll get a plaque put there for you.
This tree was planted by a southern softie. All the very best.
Thank you very much.
Clan Campbell first rose to prominence as one of the most powerful clans in Scotland during the 13th century and have had a castle on the shores of Loch Fyne since the 1400s. I'm finding out more from Alison Diamond, who's in charge of the estate's archives.
It was the second Duke that started to have the idea of building a new castle here, wasn't it?
The second Duke wanted to have a home that was worthy of him. The old castle was falling down. It was quite ruinous. It had been attacked at various times. And it also had the town right round the walls. Mm-hmm. And the town also had a reputation for having a few hostelries and perhaps places which you wouldn't really want to have right next to your castle.
Right, OK.
So as a duke, he wanted to have his own sort of more palatial seat. Mm-hmm. And he wanted to move the town away.
It's hard to imagine it was a popular move with the Duke's tenants.
You're moving people over 40, 50 years, which could cover two generations.
Yeah, really. I bet.
What became one of the earliest planned towns in Scotland was completed by the third Duke of Argyll.
He was the one who was responsible for starting to think about the town. So this was one of his early designs for where they were going to move the town to. So what you've got here is the promontory that comes out into Loch Fyne and how they might build it up and then create this sort of very organised, planned town.
However, it was the fifth Duke who finally finished the castle, 43 years after the foundation stone was laid.
So the designs for the ceilings and for some of the interiors, those are mostly through the fifth Duke.
Alison, it's fascinating what you're doing here. You've got a lot of work ahead of you, haven't you? So
absolutely.
I'll leave you to it.
A third floor and conical roofs were added on the corner towers after a fire in 1877. One man who knows all about the castle's history is head tour guide Kenny White.
Kenny, this is a room, isn't it? Look at that.
What do you think we call this room?
The armoury, maybe?
Quite right. This is the armoury hall in Inverary Castle. And this has reputedly got the highest ceiling of any private house in Scotland. 71 feet, right up to the ceiling top there.
The windows.
Oh, don't worry, we've got people to clean the windows.
This is showing not only ambition, but this is showing, indicating a lot of power.
Ambition and confidence. They were saying, look at this, we are here. We're here to stay. And they started building this castle here. They felled 1,000 trees in the estate, not for structural timber, just for the scaffolding.
The fierce Campbells fought for Scotland against the English at the Battle of Bannockburn in 1314, and after this, increased their land holdings and power across the region.
Looking around this armoury, I'm getting more than just a subtle hint of maybe the clan's handiwork previously.
Oh, yes, 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 yes. A very, very strong military tradition.
I mean, look at it. I mean, what are we looking at here?
Over 1,300 items in here. The brown base muskets, there's Highland broadswords here. You've got the targes, that's the little circular shields around the walls here. Mm-hmm. We've got breastplates here. Now, they've all been added over many, many decades, hundreds of years, in fact. From the Airy Earls, there's a breastplate over there, dates from the 1500s. You've got the brown base muskets, 18th century, who are at Culloden. Each duke has added to the collection.
The collection of more than 1,300 pikes, muskets, swords and other weapons are a reminder of the clan's former military might and the area's ancient heritage.
Well, three really strong properties spread far and wide across this beautiful country. The trouble is, I've got no idea which of those houses is Adeline and George's favourite. So let's catch up with them and find out. Yet more stunning views. This place is littered with them, isn't it?
It is, lovely.
Yeah.
This is the place to retire to, isn't it?
It is. Mm-hmm.
With or without a coat.
Absolutely.
So, you've had a bit of time to think things through. What is your favourite house?
So, we think it's the mystery property,
yes.
Property number three. It's not perfect at this point, but we think it has potential to be everything we want it to be.
Yes. We obviously have to go away and do our homework mm-hmm. to see exactly what it needs. So, definitely see if we can afford to do what we want to do with it.
So, what is it about mystery house that sets your heart racing?
It's got everything, really.
The vista.
Yep, the views. It's got a burn running through the garden. It's quiet.
Rolling hillside. Yep. Bird song.
It combined everything that the other two houses yes. had, didn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. What about that garage? Who gets that wonderful hobby room at the back with its own terrace, with its own decking?
I think that'll have to be Adeline's craft room, to be honest.
Clever choice, my friend.
Surely it's a way of shearing.
Well, you will! You've already won the battle. Don't start giving him territory now. I've really thoroughly enjoyed helping you look around this area. It offers something quite spectacular, yes. Something so different to anywhere else I've been to in the UK. And I think we've served it well, haven't we?
Yes, we have.
Yes, we have indeed.
When you do finally come to your conclusion, let us know what it is, won't you?
We will do.
Now, the mystery house, I think we've come awfully close, but of course that came with its own compromise in the form of how they reconfigured those internal spaces. So I think they're doing the right thing in taking their time and really thinking this through before they make their ultimate decision. I'm looking forward to finding out what they do next, and I wish them both the very best of luck. See you next time.
If you would like to escape to the country in Scotland, Wales, Northern Ireland or England and would like our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.